So today I'm going to be cooking for the very first time, or smoking for the very first time, bone-in ham, but I'll be doing it to get pulled ham. I'm actually going to be doing this with a pineapple glaze, Caribbean glaze, so to speak. So let's get into it, let's have some fun. More importantly, let's just see how this turns out.
You ready? Let's go!
First things first, if you plan on doing something like this, from what I've done in my research, basically you need a full bone-in ham, not spiral cut or anything like that, just a full bone-in ham. Because basically the way this is going to smoke and render is a lot like a pork shoulder. I'm not a big fan of pork shoulder, believe it or not. I've cooked them many times. They're usually really good, but I am a big fan of ham, so I thought when I seen that this recipe was being done, the pulled ham, by different people, I figured, you know what, I'm gonna try this out. I've obviously big fan, like I said, of ham, and I love smoking ham, but I've never done one to the point of pull apart. So first things first, got this knife here, and what I'm gonna be doing is essentially scoring the meat. Now, I'm not cutting all the way into it, I'm just basically scoring it, as you can see, and this is just going to allow me to get the seasoning in there to be more penetrative with this ham. So first what I'm going to do is come across like this, and again, this doesn't have to be perfect, you just want to score the meat so you can allow those seasonings to get within the ham. And what I'm going to do is just basically come back across diagonally like this. So I'm kind of creating a diamond type pattern almost, if you will. Same thing on this side. What I like to do next in this process is essentially I like to use mustard as a binder. This is a spicy mustard, it's all I had. Don't worry, you're not gonna really taste the flavor of this mustard. Again, it's just being utilized pretty much as a binder to get the seasoning to adhere to the meat. I'm also gonna be wrapping this up overnight so that seasoning really sets into the ham. I don't think you have to do it that long from what I've seen in others' experiments, but that's what I'm gonna do. Just because I like to be all about the prep and be ahead of it, so to speak. So that's what I'm going to be doing with this. Again, getting the mustard in there, getting it all covered up. Now I'm going to get this thing seasoned up, and then we'll go from there. One thing I did want to do before I actually fully season this is I'm going to basically make an injection for this. So I'm going to take some pineapple juice here. And then I'm gonna mix in a little bit of this hot sauce. Not a lot, just a little bit. And a little bit of this Malibu rum. And then last but not least, your favorite barbecue rub. I'm gonna use this Kentucky Kick. Again, this is just what I like. You can use whatever you want. And I'm gonna basically inject this into the ham. I've learned over time that the pineapple juice, I've used this for wings, I use it for pork, I've used it for a lot of different things, including steaks, tends to keep the meat extremely moist and tender during the cooking process. And since I'm adding pineapple flavors to this cook, I thought, well, it makes sense to inject it with some pineapple. So I'm just gonna come straight down here and inject certain levels. Do the same thing over here. I'm gonna go ahead and basically season this. Like I said, I'm using Kentucky Kick. It's one of my favorite barbecue seasonings. gusto vite. You can use whatever you like. Anything with some sugar in it I think is going to help, especially as it relates to ham. Now I'm just going to come back behind this and wrap this up overnight. It's going to allow both the injection as well as the seasoning just to really settle in on this ham. And like I said, I'm a big fan, a proponent of always wrapping stuff if you have the availability and time, because it does help get the seasoning settled into the meat, and usually works for me. I've never had it not work, quite frankly. So, and this works for pork shoulder just as much as it does ham. I've also used it for brisket. So I'll be doing actually a brisket flat here soon. I'll be doing something similar. Obviously the seasoning profiles will be different in it, as well as the injection, but again, this is for the first time I'll be making pulled ham. So I'm gonna use every trick in the book to make this thing turn out as amazing as it possibly can.
All right, so today's the day we're gonna be making that smoked pulled ham. I injected it, I basically covered it in that barbecue seasoning overnight, wrapped it up in saran wrap. Today's the day we're gonna make this happen. From what I understand, the goal is you gotta smoke this low and slow at 275 degrees. I'm gonna be doing that today indirect until it reaches an internal temp of around 168, and then a lot like a brisket, but a little bit different. You basically wrap it in the pan loosely with foil until it gets broken down and around 200 degrees probe tender, and then you're able to pull it apart. So let's see if this works. Let's have some fun.
As you can see, I got the Prime 6 charcoal rolling over here on the indirect side. On the Primo over here is my other side. This is where I'm going to basically be placing the ham. I'm going to be smoking this again once the temperature gets around 275, is where we're looking for, and then I'm basically going to let that roll until such time as it reaches the internal temp of 168. So let's get into it. All right, so I got the ham on there with the meter probe. Basically, again, we're going indirect 275. Hopefully we'll get an internal temp around 165, 168, somewhere in there, and then we'll wrap this up in a pan. So stay tuned, definitely more to come. Certainly look forward to see how this turns out.
Right, now it's time to make that Caribbean pineapple glaze. I'm gonna use a combination of ingredients that I believe will work for this ham. Hopefully it gives it just that enough flavor pop for everybody to enjoy it. So let's get into it and I'll show you what I'm gonna add.
First things first, I'm actually gonna be using this pineapple passion fruit preserves. I've used this before for other things such as wings. It worked out pretty good. So hopefully this will work as a pineapple glaze just as well. So I'm gonna use most of that small jar there. Next, I'm gonna add in a little bit of this barbecue provision fire honey. You can use regular honey. I just like mine a little spicy. So I'm using this fire honey in hopes that adds a little bit of kick to it. Next, I'm gonna add in pineapple juice. That's gonna help cut that a little bit. I'm also gonna add in this liqueur Malibu rum. I'm also gonna add in some hot sauce. Just a little bit though, not a lot. And then last but not least, I'm gonna add in my favorite barbecue rub, Kentucky Kick. You can use whatever you want. And then I'm gonna stir all this together and then see how it tastes. As you can see, we're right at 175. For reference, you can kind of see where I have the smokeware cap, and then down below you can see exactly where I have this, about two fingers. As you can see, looking good on this ham. Definitely come along nicely. Got some good bone pull there at the top too, so that tells me we are in the right direction. We still got about another 30 minutes or so to go before we can pull this off. Right now things look really good. The bark seems to be forming nicely on here, and I am certainly excited to see how this turns out. Ham's ready to pull off.
We're at 168 internal temp, so I'm gonna go ahead and get this pulled off, get it to the pan, show you what I'm gonna do next. Go. All right, so putting the ham glaze on. All right, next I'm gonna put some pineapple juice in there, just around this. And then last but not least, we got some of this seltzer, which is actually Allen Blast, which has real pineapple, mango, and orange juice in it. I'm gonna cover that up. I'm gonna put some pineapples on here as well as some cherries just for that nostalgic look. Then I'm gonna wrap this up in foil and then I'm gonna get it into the oven. You see, I got those pineapples, sliced pineapples and cherries on there. Got the juice down below. I'm gonna basically put a tin foil over top of this, get into the oven around 300 degrees until such time as it gets probe tender. Give you an idea what I'm talking about when I say probe tender. It's like going through butter. I mean, this thing is crazy. Oh wow. This thing is gonna fall apart. Can't wait. I'm gonna let this rest. It recommends up to about 30 minutes to an hour. I'm probably gonna let it easily go that long and then we'll go from there. Alright, so this is all come together. This is really, as you can see, looks like it's easy to pull apart. So I'm gonna start shredding up this after I've drained the juice. So I am just trying to peel this away from the bone end. The ham, as you can see, it's coming apart pretty easily. Obviously a lot of this is not going to be, or some of this is not going to be obviously edible, but you can use that bone end for some bone end ham soup. And I'm just going to basically shred all of this. It makes sense to take off of there. Look at that, ham bone secured, looking good. We'll definitely use this for something later. Look how easily that bone pulls off. All fat are definitely moving. Good thing about ham is, while there is fat in it, doesn't seem to be like all of it, you know? Pork shoulder, I don't care what you say, but there's a lot of fat. Here's some fat right here. Cut that out. Don't need all that fat, nobody's gonna eat that. Tell you what, this pulled ham, smoked pulled ham, is not anything I've done before. It's so tender. And I know I'm gonna get a lot of hate for this, but it's way better than a pork shoulder. That's why I don't do pulled pork too often. Just not a fan of it, sorry. Flavor exudes from that pineapple glaze and everything else I put on here. I'm going to pour some of that glaze back on here, wrap this up. Family's gonna be pleasantly surprised. Because to my knowledge, none of the family has ever had pulled ham before, so it'll definitely be a unique experience for them, and it's been fun cooking. Fried, smoking, and then having a pulled ham, you don't know what you're missing. This is definitely something, again, I'm going to do in the future. It was certainly worth it.